Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome on back. I'm Eris, and today we are playing Fallout 76. How's y'all's day been? Mine has been absolutely wonderful. Oops, I think I'm sticking it at least off my screen. I had a very productive day of doing just video editing. I am finally caught up with all my stuff. Also, I'm going to be showing you a really cool event that's been going on. In Fallout 76. So, let's change on over to our character. So, it is Fastnacht, I believe is how you say that, which is a German holiday for, night of fasting, I believe. Anyways, it's a German holiday, night of fasting, and from, like, the 13th to 27th, we're having, a event go on once every hour. So at least at one point during the stream today, I will be attending. Because I gotta at least show you guys what the event is. Oops. But, so today we get, we have a decision that we have to make at some point during the stream today for the main quest. And that decision is which faction we're going to work with. But, let's just take a second and see what the frick we have going on here.
Hello.
Hi, Josh. How you doing? There it goes. So unfortunately, in this wacky world, once you have stairs placed, you always have to have stairs placed, so you can't necessarily replace them very quickly. But because I play a lot on my other character, I get a lot of stuff unlocked. Rather quickly, actually. The only thing I don't have is enough concrete to be able to finish building the upstairs. But we can at least take a look at down here. Because it'd be really wacky me to at least not at least put lighting somewhere. Granted, I don't even think I have generators set up yet, but anyways, that's gonna be my focus for now. Cliff of Sticks. Is this the only base I have? I have the underworld. Oh, it's over here. We're going to activate that camp. And we are going to fast travel there. So we could get my stuff sorted. I have a feeling I have not been emptying out my inventory. Wow. Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm just sorry for that.
Okay, logging knives, parameters, loading,
Like, here I am,
ready,
just
ready to
sitting
make.
pretty waiting on a job offer that I was supposed to hear from today, but never heard from. However, it's President's Day. Yeah, President's Day. Today, so I don't even know if they were open or not. Yeah, it was like, I'm just sorry you had to deal with stuff like that. They have to deal with stuff like that in general. Just kind of sucks. Like, it annoys me when I have to deal with this. I'm sorry.
Logging naughtiness levels. Evaluation complete. Naughtiness levels exceed all projections. What has this world become?
Why would my wall not want to be walled? I also like sneezed my brains out. There it goes. Is the best way I can put it. So excuse me if I'm just like a little wonky. I am almost positive I have a cold.
Routine, silent night, failed to log, likely gone.
It was kind of just very
Knowledge,
abrupt.
society,
I just
all
nonstop.
people.
I'm not the kind of person who sneezes a million times, so it's kind of very jarring when I sneeze 5 times in a row, like 8 times today. But it's like I remember. Jeez, what do I wanna? Giants. If I'm using circuit breaker, that'll help. Anywho, I've just been a little. I'm just sorry. Is all. I'm just sorry in general. Heck yeah. That sounds super productive. Blue dates. Oh, you know what I should have looked for? I have a new obsession. And that obsession is, where is it going? There. We're just gonna. Ooh, jeez. We're gonna get a little bit closer. I forgot. This is the day I've been having. I literally just woke up from a nap. I'm so sorry. I spent 8 hours editing videos today. And then took a nap. So I'm sorry, a little like. I wish that wasn't the case. However, I spent an uncomfortable amount of time laughing at myself. It's something that's probably not even funny. Like, I was editing. I edited. I touched 7 videos today. Made them into not 7 videos. I got it down to like 5 or something. Like, did a butt ton of editing. And at some point, in these videos I was editing, it's like I played through Portal 2 in one day. Like, I didn't even bother editing any videos or anything. I just played through the entire game and just was like, ah, that's a future Eris issue. You know, it's whatever. Okay, well, today was that issue, and I was watching myself. I watched myself eat two meals during streaming. And I was eating a salad. It was just some salad. It was an okay salad. And I was at the start of a thing, like, I did the entire intro, like, what's up, everybody? My name's Eris, da, 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 da. And, I cut back into the game, and I'm sitting there eating salad. I'm like, this is a freaking good salad. And then sat there for 2 minutes, and then got into the game. And I don't know why, but just watching me eat was absolutely hilarious for no reason at all. And, like, I had to sit there and process what the frick I just witnessed. Because, like, it wasn't, like, disturbing or, like, noisy. Like, it was just watching me sit there, eat salad, go, what the fuck? That's a delicious salad. And then sit there. No context whatsoever. No, nothing. Just, that was it. That was the entirety of it. And I lost it. And I was like, I know I need a nap now. 100% I need a nap. I'm like, but I got 5 more videos to go. And then I sat there thinking about the games I get to play now that I'm done with editing. And all I have to do is upload all of them. But 45 minutes? Was it a fun character you made? Man, I don't... I'm so used to evasive that I am very weary of what I'm going to come across. So, I discovered a perk. I discovered a perk just like Christopher Columbus discovered America. Okay. Obviously, I wasn't the one who discovered it. However, I have found a perk. On my own, without being told about it. And, it's called evasive. And basically, as long as you're crouched down, enemies don't notice you unless you get too close. And so I've been using that, like, bebopping around. Hi, Nala. Where are you? You want uppies? You want uppies. Ugh, and Nala's. Nala's been having moments in life where she's been more cuddly lately. Which is not... Oh, so it was a very productive... It was a very productive event-filled 45 minutes. I see. Isn't that right, Nala's? Don't you love productive moments, Nala? Oh, so... I will not be having a guest. This will be a completely solo, solo stream, by the way. Servas, damn, okay. So, originally, I was actually supposed to be on vacation during this week. I was supposed to be in a different state during this week. No. Cheshire's not in here right now. This is Nala. I have my wonderful lady Nala on my lap. She doesn't usually come into stream. However, she's making it a habit to check in. Which I think is really cute. Isn't that right, Nulls? Cheshire's a little bit angry at me right now. Mostly because I am learning what his daily schedule is. And I keep interrupting it. End that right now. He does that every day, doesn't he? Whoops. Every single day. So Cheshire has this habit where he'll go down to the basement. He will, now that, since I've been home now, every single day for a month, he's been going down to the basement every single day and howling. They can have fun. And howling. Like, like a dog. Like a freaking dog. And, poor Cheshire indeed. Poor Cheshire. When a cat typically does that, it's because the cat wants attention. So I'll go down there and I'll give him so much love that he'll hate me. What the fuck? Oh. And then.
You looking to join up too?
And then. He'll get all mad. I'll carry him upstairs. We'll sit in this chair. And I'll hold him for a little bit, give him a ton of love until he pushes away from me to go back down to the basement to howl. Oh, cool. Well, that's fortunate for me. Marco. Up here? Oh, cool. Seriously? That's all it was. I miss my mama. I feel that, my dude. No, but he did it 3 times today. Like, he has a scheduled hour of him doing this. He will do it for an hour. From 1:15 to 2:15, he will howl in the basement. And I will interrupt him. And if I interrupt him, he will get up and he will leave me to go resume it. But if I keep doing it, he will push it to the next hour and do it again for the next allotted amount of time. Is what he does. Like, he's fully 100% choosing to do this. Ooh, a mess up a Red Riding Hood. That sounds actually really interesting. I have the information Rucker asked for.
Getting this here means
sorry,
so
Nils.
Much. Thank you.
You have Garfield wrist. Has anyone ever told you that you're a lot like Garfield?
Ellison talked my ear off.
Okay, there's the speak to Skippy. Let's go speak to Skippy and get this mission out of the way.
I'm Skippy Rorich. Something I or the Union can do for you?
It's okay, Nala. I heard you're looking for people to go out to help out in the pit.
That's right, looking for someone to help us take the fight to the fanatics.
This is Nala, for those who didn't see her.
You are interested, right?
She's massively uncomfortable with me holding her up like this, by the way, so it's not gonna be long. There you go, Nala. There you go. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to mess with you. Who are the fanatics?
Hell, you've got raider gangs here, right? I've heard about your Blood Eagles. The fanatics are something like them, but more organized. Imagine every single raider gang you've ever heard got together and decided to make like Genghis Khan. Sweep over everything. Kill anyone who won't join. And put anyone too weak to fight into forced labor camps. Everything that's not theirs they take. That's the fanatics.
Oh, interesting.
They're not here.
What's it like in the pit?
Bad. Don't get me wrong. It's home, and I want us to keep it. But we got hit bad in the war, and we've never recovered. Lots of radiation. Some areas are badly toxic, with all the junk that got blasted into the air is spread around from the factories. People are sick a lot, from one thing or another, and food can be hard to come by. Hell, some of the city's still on fire, I think. But some of the factories survived, and we got them running. Gives us access to things you can't get anywhere else. Might even be able to rebuild, if it weren't for the fanatics.
That partially reminds me of this indie game that I played. It was like called Something Red. Unfortunately, I like was the name. Something like that. But it was it's on Itch.io under horror. You play as Red Riding Hood's mother, and Red has gone missing. It's this like point and click, whatever, so you're just gathering clues and it just walks you through like the story. It's like, you remember Red left. You don't remember when Red left, but you know Red left. You know she went to go see Grandma. So you're going to follow her tracks. And you like you come across like a cabin. It looks fine, but Red's cloak is gone, and so is her basket, and so is the food. And like, you just keep going along, along, along. And eventually like, you come across Grandma, who's no longer with us because of this. And then you find Red's cloak is torn. And then eventually you find Red. So it's like really interesting. But that's what it's like your little quick description reminded me of that game. Interesting. That's really cool. Okay. I kind of connected it to a game, just the wrong game, apparently. But that sounds really cool. What'd I be doing first?
The Union's back's against the wall. We're doing our best to hold off the fanatics. Keep them from taking everything.
Occasionally, I'm eating Jell-O, by the way.
Small victories, but not a lot. Got a couple of situations back there right now where an extra hand might tip things in our favor, at least for now. I don't want to call it mercenary work, but I'm not going to lie.
It is.
You'll be going there to fight.
The pit's as bad as they say. Why not leave and let the fanatics have it?
Because it's home, damn it. Mine, ours, all of us who were born and lived there before and after the bombs. Ain't that enough? If the fanatics are out of the picture, we can rebuild. Make something out of it again. It doesn't have to stay like it is. If that ain't enough for you, picture this. A horde of fanatics, hundreds, thousands strong, setting their sights here. Sound like something you want?
Explain the Union to me. What's happening in the pit?
The Union is a sort of a, I guess you might call us a confederation or a resistance. People banding together for defense. See, there's a group in the pit. Calls themselves fanatics.
Oh,
they care
yep.
About his conquest. They want the whole
thing. Why is that at the bottom?
They roll into your area. You either join them, they force you to labor for them, or they kill you. And they're coming for everybody. The Union's the only thing standing between them and their total conquest of the pit. As much as we're able, anyway.
You're okay, Knowles. Yeah, I'm willing to help.
Fantastic. Let me just get Rucker in here. It's her bird, after all. Thanks for coming by, Rucker. Looks like we got a volunteer to take a trip out to the pit.
We've met. Had a feeling you might be up for this when you came by earlier. Guess I was right.
Figured you should be involved if we're gonna borrow your plane.
Don't let Lennox hear you call it a plane. She takes it personally. Anyway, sure thing. I guess you've already got all the ultra cells you need. I know you've got mine. Sophie and Esme tell me you helped them out too, so I expect you got theirs as well.
Interesting. Are you coming with me?
No can do, Sporia. I'll go back one day, but right now, I'm more use here. Rustle enough support to send back there. I'm not young enough to be much use on the front lines anymore.
What specifically am I going to do there?
Well, we got two different locals I know are in need of help. Locals are what we call union groups that act independently. Local 42's in the industrial district. Hacks, their leader, is struggling to keep her people alive and retake a foundry from the fanatics. We got another over in the trench working against a fanatic forced labor camp. Danilo is your contact there. Haven't heard from the other locals recently, but I'm sure we'll be hearing from them if they got trouble too. It's up to you who you want to help right now. Maybe you'll consider going back again later for the other.
Hey, I had some other questions first.
Fair enough.
What is it, Nala? What are the spiders getting out of this arrangement?
Well,
I can answer that, Skippy. First of all, we've got refugees here from the pit. People who've made it all the way down on footer and caravans. And the best way to help that situation is to help people not need to flee the pit in the first place. Second, the union's the best.
You need a hug, Nala.
The pit's got. The responders don't just want to triage in the world. We want to help it rebuild one day. We'll need allies to do that.
It doesn't hurt that we've got factories that can still make manufactured goods either.
No, it does not.
No, she's hugging my arm, so I'm assuming she wants a hug. Do you only fly out to the pit when you find suckers like me?
I prefer volunteers to suckers. I'm not running some kind of scam here.
The answer is no, by the way. We run some regular sorties, trade some supplies, carry messages. Our radios don't reach that far, so communications either us or waiting for caravans.
That's all the questions I got.
All right. All set? Got everything?
Yeah, I got everything. I'm ready to go.
This means a lot to the union. I'll make sure you're well rewarded for it. I might have some other things I need help with here in Appalachia, too. I'll let you know. Good luck up there. We're counting on you.
Okay. So we're actually not doing this today, by the way. I'm just getting this mission out of the way since I've been pushing it off for who knows how long. By the way, sorry about Nala. Not sorry. I actually don't. If you guys have a problem with my cat hugging, then that's a different issue. But, she's laying in my lap and she keeps hugging my arm, so I'm assuming she wants hugs, which, I mean, partially correct. However, she's just taking over my lap. Yes, that's a really cool character. I never thought about that, actually. I never thought of that kind of build. You okay, Nels? You want your cube? Let me know whenever you want off my lap. Okay, let's go talk to Lennox, and then we get this mission wrapped up. Then I'll show you guys what expeditions are, since I don't really touch them. I've only ever done one.
Whoa.
And not on stream.
Oh, you look interesting. What's up? I'm Lennox.
Hi, Lennox. You have the same vibe as Baby J. Is this actually going to get us all the way to the pit?
Fully fueled up, she'll get us there, no problem. Us and any friends you want
to bring along.
And back, in case you were worried about that. Unless someone hits us with an RPG or something. I'm like, 85% sure that won't happen.
Anyone else? No, you're okay. Do you want to sit on my lap? I'm just going to be moving a lot, so I just don't want to be disturbing you, babe. It's okay. I'm sorry. I won't mess with you. I'm hands off. Have you been to the pit before?
First place we checked out after we got the old girl working again. Far enough to prove her out, close enough for our fuel. The city's in bad shape. Real bad. Of course, I only saw it from the sky, mostly. I stay with the bird and leave the hiking to others. They only shot at us a little when we flew over. Not too bad. Yeah. Nothing she can't handle. We got a safe LZ.
Only a few shots.
Didn't happen again. Probably.
Okay, you're my ride to the pit.
Yeah, right on. About time we made another trip out there. I mean, me and my girl here. You haven't been, I guess. Rucker said somebody'd be coming by. Guess you're it. If you're all set, I'm ready when you are. She's all fueled up for the trip out and back. I'm a miracle worker in the sky, but even I can't make a fly on willpower alone.
Designed for her. I was like, obviously you have to have the red cloak. However, I'm assuming that she's going to be grown-esque. I think we got everything we need. Okay.
Girl ready for takeoff, and you just tell me when you're ready.
So like, obviously the Red Riding Hood would have to have, you know, the classic cloak. Could have the cloak be enchanted with something that either masks her, or the cloak itself could be the curse that makes people forget. However, that's character fundamentals. I would do brunette. I don't know why, but Red Riding Hood seems like a brunette to me. It might be how fairy tales have been depicted throughout life. But, like, brunettes usually seem to have their heads on straight, whereas in, like, stories, it's like the blondes are usually the ones getting saved all of the time, and Red Riding Hood shouldn't be the one getting saved. In this case, because she's the one doing the hunting. Oh, no. I guess I'll have to hit this again and at the top of the next hour. Okay, so we got that done. So down to 3. Sir Overseer. Let's do this one. We're going to start. We're going to be working on both missions. However, I do need help. I've never thought about her as Ginger, honestly. I don't know why. Probably because they're very, really rare. But, like, my opinion, I'd go brunette. Or a copper tone. Like, you could go Ginger, but, like, on the dark side of Ginger.
Seems like the Vault Dweller from 76. What is it?
But, we're gonna shoot ourselves in the foot a little bit. Because I'm gonna work with both the foundation and then creator. But I do need help making a decision on who we're gonna go with at some point. So I don't think we'll get as far as to need to make a call tonight. Because they're pretty hefty missions. But let's just see where we get to. And
what? You wanna see. That's a little outside of our usual. Obviously paranoid about security. Lasers, turrets, super thick walls. This is about that treasure, isn't it? So it's not Bull after all. It's in this vault, and you want us to help you get it.
Deal. I can definitely do that. It's not about the treasure. We want to build a new currency.
You got some grand scheme to reignite the basis of capital and all that other money talk the lobbyists on the Hill would always yammer about. That's all well and good. But my concern is how that gold can help us right here, right now. How it can help the people of Foundation. Look, let's say I believe you. A structure like this, you need some serious equipment to do any demo work.
If I got that equipment, you'd be on board?
Yeah.
we could start thinking about the rest of this nonsense. Laser tripwires? How the hell are we gonna handle that? Oh well, one thing at a time. You get us a big enough drill, we can find the right spot to hit. Every structure's got its weak point.
I know a drill we can use. The mother load from Hornwright Industrial.
The mining conglomerate, right? Yeah, that might just work. I'll start talking to folks about how we can crack the rest. You keep up your end, we might just be in business.
I'm not excited. I don't like this one. I don't like this mission specifically. I'm gonna put a little bit into sneak, but I am very weary over what the frick we're doing. Okay. So, my thing about this mission is that I'm gonna get my butt kicked 100%, no hesitation, completely laid flat. By Hornwright. Y'all ready to see this? It's not going to be right now. It's going to be at our third location? I'm using the wrong gun. So glad I've already done this mission. So, fun fact, I have a mannequin in my far corner, so if you see me ever, like, do that, that's why. I forgot my mannequin's back in my office. But, on my other character, I didn't do this mission yet. So I had to do both Hornwright and then I had to do the mother load. I'm gonna surprise. Oh, hi. So I kind of got really overwhelmed really fast. But right now we're just going down to the bottom, I think. We gotta see. C4. Seriously. Frickin', you know how many times I've come down here? I've come down here so many times. Only on stream is there ever actually mole men down here. There's only one behind me. There it is. Jeez. Hey. Pardon you. Where'd you come from? Only whenever I come down here on stream, what the fuck? Do I ever get, mole men? Every freaking time. I don't get it. We're just gonna do that. Just so I'm not over encumbered. Use mother load terminal. Control terminal.
User detected. Connecting. Connection established. Debug process initiated. Attempting to make contact with primary transponder signal. Primary transponder signal not found. Senior executive Daniel Hornwright not found.
Nope, why would he be? So we have to find the estate card. No! My Jell-O! Okay. You know, I don't, I'm gonna have to come back here because Summer Villa, Orilla Cabin, let's just bebop over there. Dude, my Jell-O, I haven't made Jell-O in a very long time and I've just been like cleaning out all like processed stuff. Because, like, if I'm already feeling like crap, then I might as well just keep eating it until it's gone. Instead of just throwing it all away. Because I don't have the money to overhaul an entire pantry into organic food. But my gosh. This Jell-O is the biggest disappointment. What the frick? Why on earth is there just a marker at Horn, right? Like, bruh. Man, you know, I want to live in a house like this someday. I don't know what to do with this much space, but... like, it would probably be really nice. Probably become like a family estate or something. Hornwright. Um, But wouldn't that be cool, living like a big old house like that? Like, I want to live in a house that's a pool and a hot tub. Oh, why don't I freaking hate this scope. Why do I have this? I'm a terrible shot. Okay. There's another tattered dress over there. So, safe and sound. Nobody's there yet. Ooh, I haven't been down there at all. Oh. This event just ended. You know what? Let's go talk to Meg. Because I'm going to have to bebop down there, and it's going to take me a hot second, so I might as well just get a bunch of both perspectives going. Pardon me eating Jell-O out of a tall jar with a short spoon. I like to apparently make myself struggle.
Inoculation worked like a charm. We've established your usefulness, but don't mistake our gratitude for hospitality. Yet here you are. It tells me you're not here just to waste my time. You want something. It must be important, else you wouldn't be barging in here like you run the place. Out with it.
There's a treasure in Appalachia. It's real. The treasure here in Appalachia, it's real. Locked in 79.
Well, if that don't pique my interest, please go on. What exactly, pray tell, is inside this Vault 79?
Cool. I will check it out in a hot sec, in a jiffy. That's for me to know and you to find out.
You playing with me, fool? You better out with it before you try my patience. What's in the vault?
U.S. Treasury's gold, all of it.
This is a fascinating turn of events, ain't it? The things I could buy with that gold. You know, I heard rumors about it round here. Of course, the last sucker who tried to use the location of the trove as a bargaining chip is still dangling from a wire outside as we speak. Liars get wires, you dig? So let's pretend for a moment I don't believe you. What you got to convince me?
I like that design. That is
That doesn't surprise me as much as the others. I mean,
the first one you sent me, I mean. Sorry, I opened up the first one so far. I like that design. That was kind of what I was picturing. Give me a second. By my count, you see a supply shortage. Can you afford not to trust me?
To one of them vaults sure would set us up for a while.
It's like the outfit from the first one is what I imagined, but it's like with the cloak of the second one. It's kind of what came to my mind. And then of course Red Riding Hood having darker hair, however, the hair color I would completely leave up to you. I do like the medieval-esque cloak, design on the first one. Is just how I imagined her involved was like the second cloak with the first outfit. Like along with like the scar and everything actually. Just darker hair. If that makes sense. I dug up some schematics from a VTU. Would you be convinced if I showed them to you?
Shit. You know I could just kill you and take this, right? You got a lot to learn before you can roll with us, 7-6.
I'm not stupid. Why do you think I haven't given you a location of the vault yet?
Ooh, I like the cut of your jib. Maybe there is hope for you. Toss it up on the board and let's see what you got here.
Honor means nothing. Survival means everything. And here is a vault.
All right. Seems pretty legit. I assume you're coming to me because we got the skills to get into this here vault. But you know, we ain't gonna do this out of the goodness of our hearts, baby doll. Oh no, no. The goods inside. So we
Cheshire!
An agreement here, see? I supply the people power. You supply the location. We all get inside, we nab the goods, you get a nice fair little cut, and we all make out like bandits, you dig?
And I suppose we just trust each other not to screw each other over?
Showing your cards early, 7-6. I may be a nasty cutthroat survivor, but I stick by my word. I won't yank your chain. Not like that bitch Rose.
So, like, I like the outfit of the first one. That outfit show, like, says, not to mess with me. However... See, I'm not feeling the cloak of the first one. Sounds good to me.
So, first things first. We gotta have a plan to crack that big-ass vault door wide open, right? Easy peasy, light and breezy. That's a job for Lucky Lou, our demo expert. If he can't explode it, then it ain't from this earth. Now, Lou can be a real shut-in on account of his, skin condition, but I trust him more than just about anybody.
His skin condition.
In his room down below. Introduce yourself. Fill him in on the plan, then do whatever prep work he needs you to do. You dig?
Oh, go talk to Lou.
Right on, 7-6. Do your thing. Just try to keep it down low, all right? I want the entire camp knowing what's going on.
Like I'm halfway.
Only tell who I say to tell you.
I want to see how this mission kicks off with the Raiders. Like I've seen how it kicks off with the Foundation. Like, it's really cool. You get access to something really cool. But, like, the Raiders, I don't think you get anything special. I haven't seen the third one yet. Okay. The third one feels very classic to me. Like, what you'd expect Red Riding Hood to be wearing. But, I don't know, there's something, like, kind of innocent about it. It's like the second one, like, it's like, says, I live in the woods, whereas, like, the first one's like, hi, I'm just visiting, don't mind me. In my opinion, at least. But, Lou. Gone forever, don't get nebby, and come looking. I ain't gonna be an eyesore around here no more. I already told Fisher he's got claim to all my stuff. The rest of you can fight over the scraps. Frickin' dude. It's like, cause I like the third. It looks very, traditional. It's like, first one is like, I'm just gonna say overall what each one like makes me think. First one says, "Don't mess with me. I could take you out. I could take you out." Second one's very stealthy, very I'm one with the woods. And the first one is very traditional. It's like what you'd imagine Red Riding Hood to be, like what you imagine her to be in the stories and everything. It's like if anything, if you are attached to the third, it's like you said something along the lines of during BA by day, this scared little girl at night. Anything you can make it an infliction, where Red Riding Hood literally is two. But I don't know. My skill is four. What? You mean my skill is four and I still can't unlock a terminal? Because, like, there, you could be, like, a Shrek Fiona situation. Where, like, Fiona was beautiful princess by day, ogre at night. You can make it something similar to that. But, like, Red Riding Hood, fighter by day, by night, reverts back to her childhood self. Before anything happened. Dang it. Is what you could lean towards if you wanted. If you could decide between one design and the other. Like you could do something like that. Am I wasting a... Am I wasting a slot with a hacker? I think I might be. I'm just looking for a password reset, my dude. There we go. There we go. Fake note. Duct tape fuses. Outgoing messages. Denied. Incoming messages. Denied. Tech logs. Okay. Yeah, let's go talk to this dude.
You're the new gal, aren't you?
I sure am.
Talking with Meg and poking around. That brings you to me.
I'm new around here. I'm just trying to get to know everyone.
Well, that sort of friendly optimism may have worked in the vault, but if it does, it's just as likely to get you killed. At the very least.
It would in the vault too.
Neophyte, and people around here. Take advantage of
neophyte? Hey. He said neophyte. My legs, I just walked over from there.
Oh. Hey, that was funny, yeah. But really, what can I do for you?
Interesting. That one just erases the idea of the cloak in general and gives a, open face skirt instead. That's interesting. I found a note from Lou says he took off and mentioned you in it. What do you know about his disappearance? I don't necessarily hate the outfit.
Maybe he was just tired of being cooped up in that hole of his and went for some fresh air.
Like, I couldn't see, like, shorts underneath. But it's like, there is like the bandaged leg going on with it. It's an interesting design. I do like it. I know you got a device to track that you can use to track Lou that you prefer no one else knows about it.
Did you go into my lab and hack into my terminal? That was private. I knew you were nothing but trouble. I should shoot you right where you stand.
I'm just trying to help Lou.
Well, here's the thing about that. I haven't been completely honest with you. But it's not what you think. I had to do it. I promised Lou I would try to throw people off his trail if they came looking for him. I was hoping he'd return by now, and this wouldn't be necessary.
That would be a really cool concept, actually. If you mix those two, yeah.
It's more glum than usual.
I could get behind that. That would be really cool. Did something bad happen to him recently?
Nothing I'm aware of. Nothing truly bad.
But honestly, they would mix together really well.
If I was still a religious man, I would say God watches over him.
They already are very similar.
Lou here on this earth, Lou's one of the luckiest men alive. He's over 95 years old and still fit as a fiddle, sharp as a tack. I witnessed over a dozen times. Something should have rightly killed any normal man, but not Lou.
Is Lou so lucky, then why would he leave like this?
To be honest, I don't know. He came to see me before he left.
I think she would be too.
But I think he said something about feeling like a burden. He's never been a burden on anyone. He gives to himself and does more than his fair share of work.
It's like, because like they both have the corseted waist. So it's like, if you did the corseted waist, the open skirt, and then did like the whatever is going on with the second one, the pants of the second one, like they blend in really well together because they already are a similar design. Just one has a bit more than the other, so you can easily balance them out that way. But yeah. Do you have any idea where he might have gone?
Not exactly. But I did send out a friend of mine to go find him, just before you showed up. She's a tracker. Best I've ever known. Unfortunately, she hasn't come back yet.
You guys are my favorite character?
My friend's not the best conversationalist, and Lou's stubborn. Maybe you can go and mediate. Talk some sense into old Lou.
Yeah, so listen, tell me where I need to go.
Oh, right. pardon me. Since my tracker buddy went off alone, I rigged up a tracking beacon I could use to find her, just in case she ran into trouble and wasn't able to make it back. I don't think that's the case here, but fair warning, this might lead you to a dead end. In this case, I'm sorry. You can use your Pip-Boy to track the beacon's radio signal. The closer you are, the more it will ping. It should get you to where you need to be.
Thanks, I'll go meet your tracker.
And, I hope Lou's okay when you find him.
Okay, so here's my thing. I need to go stop off at med base first before we do this. I'm so excited to meet this tracker. I can't wait for y'all to witness the comedy that is this person. They're so funny in such an unfortunate way. I think it's hilarious. Like, I do have a halfway awareness of what the Raiders do. I never did anything beyond Lou, though, with the Raiders. My bad. Lou and Ra-Ra. But that was kind of a I kind of got irritated and moved on because I wanted to see the... So I wanted to see what the stealth armor was about, but I have lost my intrigue in that. Level 20, we're about level 30, so we'll be trading up soon. Ooh, I haven't sold AIDS in a hot second. Okie dokie then. Scrap kit. Actually, let's keep our scrap kits on us. We're gonna need those. Notes. That's a person. Weapons are not a permitted response.
Gathering presents, loading cheer, unpacking Holly Jolly. Subroutine complete. Oh.
Wait. No, they left. Oh my gosh, wait, you're here. Oh, thank you so much!
You're so welcome. It's got a carry weight bonus to it, too.
Thank you! I appreciate it so much! Holy crap!
Error. Report. This unit attempted to decorate local fauna with a Rudolph nose. Failure case feature. Possessed two heads. Cannot resolve.
Holy cow. Oh, that's so cool. Okay. Gotta pick you up so I can put you away so I don't have to use you right now. Claim you. Yep. Gotta claim ya. Holy crap. That's so freaking cool. I gotta put all this in my...
Happy holidays.
In here, for now. Holy crap! Okay. That was wild. I don't even... Wish guess. We want to. Okay. We're gonna go over to Crater real quick. Should we? Actually, let's do an event. Because we're gonna do a couple of events before we go do Crater. Because I want to show you Frostknock. And if I start this mission with Lou, I'm not going to be able to show you Frostknock in time. And I want to show you this. It's super broken, by the way. Super broken. But it's really cool. It's always broken for me. So we're going to do a couple of events. Back to work. Okay. Okay, so we're gonna have a butt ton of... Oh, hi friend, you're right there. Why is this... Oop, why are you all super mutants? Why is it suddenly all super mutants? Oh. Oh, shoot. My big bad level 58 in this. Got that? Cool. Can I pick this up? I can. Okay. So I can collect things while I'm going. Mother fricker! He got that. I'm gonna follow this dude and make sure he gets back up there. So, y'all keep the door closed. Okay. Just gonna wander around a little bit. So, the other one is, I'm assuming, up that way. Over this way, I'm assuming. Yeah, you're up there. Okay.
I seem to have slacked off. I'll report for duty right now.
What is it?
I'm gonna follow this one and just make sure he survives.
Ah!
Jeez, my rifle sucks. Okay, well. Keep going, friendo. Okay, well, I'm gonna keep on my wonderful little way. Yeah, I've been relying on bats a lot lately, just so you know. What happened? Oh. What happened, dude? Dude, why are you so far away?
No, you get back to work.
Jeez. Oh, I miss. Okay. Oh, this event sucks. Oh, jeez. Okay, let's go search up here. I'm going to assume that this place is all mostly, that he took the time to clear this place out before starting this. Irritates people that I just don't sit on area. Well, hello there. You're very friendly for someone who's about to probably get moited. Yeah, I bet. That's so boring for you, just coming in and squashing someone's Halloween party.
Time to die.
There we go. With 5 minutes to spare before my event starts. Man. I'm excited. I'm excited for Fastenach. I don't know if I can say Fasten. Fastenach.
Good day to you. Hello
there. Got 10 seconds. I'm gonna sit pretty with Billingsley.
Hello there.
There we go. And as long as I'm here at the end of it, we're good. I also, like, have no ammo. That's why I'm not fighting.
Hello there. Good day to you.
Okay.
Good day to you.
It's a truly despicable trait or a flaw that's intentionally bad. I mean, a trait intentionally bad or flawed. Let's go over there. Why? I don't know why you just got disconnected from chat, but, flaw. I mean, you could make Rizik really a werewolf, but that would be predictable. You can make her afraid of the dark. You could do a thing involving, you could do, like, a curse if you wanted. It'd most likely be a nature-based curse, if anything. Oh, I think the server's breaking. Here, I'm gonna plant myself right over here. We're just gonna play some music. I'm gonna get yelled at, I'm not wearing my power armor. Those are the people who are running, wandering together. Man, I don't have a lot of junk on me. This character, I do not have... I don't have a lot of... So, my other character, I have so many clothes. I'm gonna go...
Time for indulgence before a time of night. Thatcher's best, and truth be told, only that's not a celebration.
Whee! I'm probably not gonna even get there in time. So I took the long route. There we go. I mean, that would be a pretty decent thing to have as an infliction. It's just the fear itself. Unless you wanted to step it up at all and just... I don't know. Because man, this digging bot, this thing a robot kills me. Like any insecurity can create a dilemma. What the frick did I just shoot? Interesting. I mean, that would be a pretty decent one. Oh my gosh, this is gonna be this character's first Fashnok. I'm excited. I have a bunch of the masks. Each time you do it, you get a new mask. There's a bunch of rare ones that you can get. Like the wolf one that Sheikah is wearing, Diagon. Is one of them you can get. That's one of the rare ones, actually. Okay, let's... I wanna... hit, I'm gonna get myself a ton of rads. I wanna hit up the mall. And fix up my stuff. Before I go and mess with the raiders. Merry Fastnacht. So Fastnacht is a German festival that they celebrate to push Mr. Christmas away, the winter demon, if you will. Is my understanding of this holiday, and we get to participate in a little fun parade. But also, that kind of attachment itself could lead to a lot of issues. Like, if you look at how Batman and the Joker behave, it's like, I remember there was that one scene where Batman got, his identity got released. Got revealed by Scarecrow ripped off his mask and completely ruined the entire game. Joker being so disappointed in finding that out. Like, there's a lot of devastation that can happen from it. You really like your thing, huh? Here we are. I'm only doing this so I can specifically, get, ammo out of this. Just so I don't want to have to go make more ammo. See, at some point, I'm gonna run around playing this game, just area chat, just to see how it goes. I don't know if I could do that on stream, though. See, I freaking love playing this game. However, you can run out of things to do really fast. That's dope. That's Goyle. So, here's the downside of this. Suiciders spawn like no one's business in this. Squirrels. This is how you know when people use bats, by the way. Because, like... Oh, that's a chicken. Clearly, it doesn't look like I use bats because my character can't aim for crap. I don't have a high enough agility. Where? Mother trucker. This event also allows you to level up really fast. Jesus. It well. Motherfricker! Jeez! So, the reason. You good, demon? Demolisher! I was reloading! This is why I use pistols, guys. This event, it's so hard to do when you're a low level. It's so hard to do. But when you're a high level, freaking, you're here for all the craps and giggles. And, like, it just, like, cracks me up. I have my frame rates in my top corner for my own entertainment. because freaking that's so freaking cool. I want a jetpack backpack. Throw out the Fallout first. I need to use that power armor at some point, though. I can make this player into a power armor player, actually. But... there we go. In this event, there'll always be a legendary sloth that shows up. And that's how you get your special perk. Gleeful Butcher. Your mask is terrifying, my dude. I love that. People always shoot this. That's the thing that kills me. I freaking love this event. Nope. Garland and a beer stein. Peril, which mask do we get? Scorch base! Look, I got that! Oh, I actually freaking love that. Okay, let's head on over to the mall. Just because I should be able to upgrade my armor now. Hopefully. To have better looking armor. If not, then I can at least put an outfit on. Because there's a certain time when I do enjoy looking like a beefed up warrior. Not always. Heck, my other character runs around in a swimsuit. Kind of cracks me up. Oh, I forgot to go. I did not hit mall, huh? Upsa, popsa, upsa. Sorry, one second. Sorry, my mom is very on edge hearing back about potential opportunities and whatnot. All right, T-K. Armor chassis. I wanna... jeez, a full set of 45. Do I not have a mechanics outfit? How dare I not have a mechanics fit? Wow, that sucks. Okay. That are over to weapons. My stuff's not out of commission just yet. Combats. I want to scrap those. T-45, Sturdy Raider. Jeez. Yeah, I'm not... Oh, that's why. I'm not high enough level for them just yet. I'm really close, though. Okay. Over here. Kinda. Expert. I'm not high enough level for master yet. Okay. I'm gonna start doing this one so I can do that. Ow, mother trucker, I knew it. Let's do that. Scrap that. I need a pharma. Wow. Some perk cards. Bloodsucker inspirational. Perceptibobble. I don't... Why do I have two? I don't care for bobbleheads. Okay. We're gonna store this stuff until I'm a higher level. Let's see if I can craft. I mean, that is a solid. Do I not? Oh, I can't. Wow. Wow. That's why my armor looks so effed up. I don't have the chest piece yet. Armor. That's notes. Combat torso. Okay. Man, that's a fair way to spend the day. I was gonna read today. I was so motivated. I was like, oh yeah, once I get all my videos done, then I'm gonna read. And then I ended up doing a burn it journal. Hello, you want to sit on my lap again, baby? Or are you just vibing? You're just vibing. Give me 1 second. I want to go get Cheshire. I'm a little weirded out that he hasn't come to join me yet. Since you grew up as an apartment cat, I never know the outdoors, baby boy. But like that. Yeah. I mean, I got insulted yesterday, but it was via insult bot on Fallout. There you go. Cheshire was sleeping on his bed. Look how cute the Cheshire boy is. Look how cute he is. So sleepy. There you go, baby boy. I'm sorry. You had a very productive day of howling at mama. Josh says, hey, handsome. My cute little baby boy. He is already falling back asleep. He got wiped out. He spent almost all day outside today. Oh, wait. I never even read the thing. Man, freaking, Joshua's gonna have a great day tomorrow. So if he's gonna be equally as he was today, he's going back outside. Let's switch over to modify. I need to, Sorry, Cheshire. Someday when I get a nice computer chair, we're gonna have so much fun. Reinforce. What's padded even do? Oh, reduces explosions. Nah. Okay. I want leaded at some point. Armor. So we got 20. It's going down though. Yeah, it goes down a lot. But. Oh. I'm glad you got it working at least. Like, I still have to go find the rest of my... I still have to go hunt for mods. Granted, my computer has not been the happiest of campers as of lately. So, I mean, standard. Oh, automatic. I don't like automatic. TR. I don't have aluminum. I wish Skyrim... So Skyrim is a great game. I wish it wasn't as sensitive when it comes to character. Just characters in general. Oh, Chachi doing big wash.
Protect and serve.
Do you, madame? What is it? Is it aluminum? Because that would be absolutely amazing, Helena, whatever your name is. But you don't seem to have adhesive. Not adhesive. Yeah, but it shouldn't be this. Skyrim shouldn't be this broken, is my thing. Like, you wouldn't think that a game like would break this bad. You just wouldn't. I'll open up! Okay. I need to sell my drugs. I gotta sell some drug-a-dugs. I also have to get an outfit. I just... freaking... You know what I hate? Looking for outfits. I just hate that. There we go. That. See what I can craft. Oh. So I can't make. Yeah. I can make 45s. Let's go with 30. There we go. That's a decent amount. Okay. Vending machine. Ammo. Ooh, yeah, you still don't have what I want. Okay. Now I'm broke again. I need to sell my drugs. Before I forget again. Oh, I don't need that. Let's put that back. Blood back. Leave that alone. Here, we'll go down to the bottom. We're just gonna... Now, let's put these away. Yeah, I know, I haven't opened up that box yet. It's fine. It's fine. I'm just a hoarder. You know what I want so badly? I want a bobblehead collection. Like, I want to get, like, the Charisma bobblehead or something. Like, I want a Fallout bobblehead. Really badly. I don't know why. I just really do. I feel like it'd be really fun. No. I've learned... I could never be one of those people who uses chems in this game. I just never remember. There we go. Okay. Do I have anything else? Fire breather. So I don't have any outfits I actually like to wear. Because I always wear mechanics. But. Anyways. Let us go back up here. Doesn't matter which way we go. Isn't that right, Tim Tom? I love you so much. You cute little barn cat. You know your mama lives on a farm, right? You like your foot in your mouth? I like putting your foot in your mouth, huh? Okay. Now, since we're close by... Wait, Is this a young camp or is this a new camp? Okay. Radio, do I have... Jeez. That. This is a new camp. Okay. Oh, cool! Okay, I'm assuming it's over by that cave. Are you trying to leave me, Chicky? Tiki Tiki Tumbo. Why are you trying to leave me, baby boy? Don't touch me. Hi, Tiki. You really gotta sit right there, my dude. Smelling like Jell-O. Oh, it's up more. Is it here? It do be here. Carlton? Bro! What the frick, Cheshire? Sorry. Cat sat on my keyboard. Stop it! You no longer have desk privileges. You lost desk privileges, my dude. No. I apologize for the technical difficulties of my darling little Chimshire. Yeah, eat my cords. Eat my tassel. Eat this. Let's meet my favorite person in this entire game.
Hello. I was not expecting anyone.
I'm looking. Who are you?
I am Weasel. I am here to find a friend who.
Is there something wrong with your voice? So here's the thing. I freaking love watching her talk. What kind of words do I have trouble with?
The vocals, box cable, part list was not complete. For example, there are no bad words. I have been trying to say bad words this whole time, but they do not come out. I try. I can say them in other ways.
Yeah, so this character, her, like, lips don't match up. You know, those other characters do. Hers don't. I assume it's a her. I assume Weasel's a her. How does the call let you speak? Cheshire was learning how zippers work, apparently. Don't worry, I'm legitimately, like, I threw this on because I didn't want to put on a hoodie. Is why I have my onesie on. Weasel, that's an unusual name.
Snitched. Talk.
Never mind. No time to chat. Where's Lou? After we already chat. Yeah, you're a tracker, not a fighter, huh? Kip. I'm really excited. This unlocks one of the best armor in the game. This better be good. Lou, is that you? Because Yin's not. You don't know me. I'm here on behalf of Fisher.
Fisher? Why that? I told him I didn't want nobody to come for me. What's anyone doing?
Is he from Jersey? Need you for a job.
Nah, I'm retired. I just decided it. Yin's gonna take your job, turn it sideways, and put it where the sun don't shine.
How about you take the job and I'll put you out of your misery? Look, if I have to drag you out of here myself, I will.
Good luck, dipshit. I won't be waiting for you.
Wizzle's probably sitting here like, I want to say that. Over here? What about it? Can we fix... If you side with the Raiders, can you fix Weasel's collar? That's what I want to know. What am I looking at? Are you a Weasel? Explode. Sounds like you know what you're doing. Let's try it.
I have done this kind of work with Lou before. Stand back. I will set up the big boom.
Oh, Tishy's all playful now. Okay, let's go over here. Chicky! Ticky, tick, ticky, ticky, tick. I don't mind that. Tickin', tickin', tickin'. Pretty little tickin'. Ticky, ticky, ticky. Ticky, ticky, ticky. Pretty little ticky. The more I talk, the more he wants to shush me, so he touches my mouth. Take it, take it, take it. There you go, Ticken. Bye, baby. Thank you for hanging out. The tail waggles. Okay. Let's go find Lou. Try to do this. So we're gonna trigger warning for anybody who does not, for anybody who has any sort of mental health things that have made some sort of attempts in their lives. This entire mission, okay? Just this entire mission. There it is. Nope, in fact, did not. Do I have things set to search? I don't think I do. Do I? Here, let me check. Over to junk. Components. I do not. Okay. Need that. Search. Work. Blood. Glass. Gears. Just our basics, you know. That just lets me know if it's high importance. That's stuff I'm always looking for. How many shotguns has he gone through, man? 4. New plan. This makes no dang sense. It was such a simple idea. Sit in the chair. Since the other day, I've gone through 3 chairs and 4 shotguns. I've had jams, misfires, broken chair legs, bad aim, and every other thing. I should have known everything in this mine would be rusted to heck. No way I was trying this on myself unless I'm sure it'll work. I'm here to die and not get maimed. Time for a new plan. Engine room. I found another one of them ghouls in this mine tonight. He looked just like me, but his mind was fried. I tried talking to him stupid. He just ran at me. If Lev's right, I could turn into one of those things anytime. Yeah, there's only one way out of this. I'm not sure I can pull a trigger on myself. I keep losing my nerve. I'm an engineer, dang it. I'll think of something. Maybe I should take the human element out of it. I'll need a workshop. This engine room will work if I stash all the corpses somewhere. Cool. Well, let's go this way, because that door's locked. I'm not excited for what's happening. Okay. I need a better scope on this gun. I'm not excited. Turret repair. Finally stop the turrets in the next room from firing every random critter that runs by. Now they'll only activate when I press the red button. I'll be leaving on my own terms, not some dang rats. Okay. There we go. Very effective. I should have taken at least a single shot at it, then I would have gotten some loot. Okay. A weapon for Red. Sorry, I probably missed this a hot second ago. Well, are you going semi-industrial or are you staying medieval? Like, yeah, a bow would be a little bit. Is like a bow would be a little bit more less personal, and if she's functioning with like a vendetta, then I would say something either like single wield sword or daggers, maybe, is what I would think if you're sticking to more traditional. Turrets. I found a store of military grade turrets in an old observatory to the south. No idea why they needed the firepower. It's mine now. These turrets are in good shape. I've tested a few and they all seem to work. I still can't bring myself to walk around one, but I have a new plan to work around that. Trial run 2. Turrets all keep set. Turrets are all set up, but the giant hideous rats keep running through the room, setting them off. Okay. Okay, so what I see is traditional. Okay. Like traditional in D&D world. Cause like, this Red has a vendetta, so I feel like she would be doing things face to face. That's why I say either a sword, like a two-handed sword, or daggers, is what I was thinking, but. Oh. That would play with the character, at least. I forget that silver affects werewolves. Turrets all set up, but those giant hideous rats keep running through the room, setting them off. Their corpses are liquidy. Makes my stomach churn, thinking that that will be me. Tremors also have been a problem. Yeah, tremors yesterday, I replaced all the turrets' wiring, and then a small quake set them off. Somehow they ended up targeting each other, now I need new turrets. I'm starting to sour this whole dang plan. Failure. Okay, I'm done here. Everything was set up perfectly today. I was eating another last meal over by the excavator, and then a dang rock fell on the button and activated the turrets. They targeted me, but the excavator blocked most of the fire. Two of the rounds grazed my arm. This hurts worse than I thought it would. What the heck was I thinking? I hate this place. I don't want to die, but I can't let myself become one of those things. I know what I have to do. If my heart ain't in it, dang it. Back to the drawing board. Like, silver makes a lot of sense. I feel like a claymore would be really cool to have for her character. Okay. Here's that. Man, I freaking love Weasel. That was a lot more shots than it needed to be. What's up with the tremors? Chamber. Red trusts a lot of things in life. All that computer crap was too finicky. New plan, death by heavy machinery. I need more supplies to finish the building. To finish building the chamber, it needs more support. Each time it sets the Each time it sets the... Oh, wait, I can read. Each time I test it, the room tremors and the mind gets worse. Now that happens almost every time I turn it on. Am I causing them somehow? I mean, that would check out. I'd follow that. Okay. Goodbye, world. Well, woo. Look at the phone. I'm pretty sure I'm on my own at this point. Weasel was supposed to come with, however, Weasel got locked out. Oh, there it is. Can you fight, Weasel? You have a gun. Why are you not using it? I mean, that's valid. If you're gonna hurt you, so I wouldn't either. There you go, Weasel. You did a good job. Such a good job, Weasel. You did so good. Yeah, I'm collecting frogs. Why? I don't know. I just am. I feel like it's the thing to do. Dude, I deep cleaned my entire house and like moved things around. Ooh. I don't think I've ever had this bad of allergies. Like, so I'm allergic to dust. Fun fact. Makes for a really fun time. Makes for a really fun time cleaning, I should say. So like I decided to deep clean my entire house, I dusted it. My goodness. Hi, friend. It's like I can sleep without, you know, suffocating. But now I've been sneezing nonstop. Again. So I had this children's storybook game toy. And it was like this plastic book and it had like buttons. And you could press buttons and it'd create a story. And how Weasel talks reminds me of that. Like, I made a bowl of mom's spaghetti. I made a bowl of mom's spaghetti last night. Is how it, like, would talk. Like, that was one of the buttons we just kept pressing. Like, the buttons would tell you one story. It'd tell you the installed line. And it was like, I made mom's spaghetti, Goofy, last night. Oh, fun! I love that name! Yeah, I was like just hearing like big boom again. Just reminded me of that like stupid storybook thing. I think my mom still has it to this day. Man, I wish they made toys like they used to. That crap was funny. Isn't it right now? You remember Mom's Spaghetti? Yeah, you're not very good with words. It was like the goofy thing killed me.
So you think you're... Okay, I'm listening. You gone through all the trouble not to get here. Well, I'd have to stop an old man from off himself. What do you want?
Off yourself, you're trying to commit suicide?
That's what I said. Did I stutter? It ain't obvious. I'm one of them rad set ghouls. Been that way going on 25 years. Ain't no way to live.
So you were in your 70s when it happened.
The only way to keep people safe. Of course, that's harder than you think.
Oh. Right. Interesting. That's an interesting way to keep the character's name down. How's killing yourself keeping people safe?
You see them fears, right? Only a matter of time before I'm one of them. I don't want to kill nobody. We ain't got a good reason to be killed. It's bad enough I look like a monster. It's a whole nother thing to kill just because something moves.
There you go. Don't you work with the Raiders, though?
That's different. We don't kill nobody for no reason. We offer mercy. We let people join up. We're as bad as you think. We give them a choice. We only kill if we need to.
Interesting. I finished my Jell-O. Touché. German accents are really hard. So that's fair. Maybe it's not that bad.
Indians ain't making a good case if you want my help.
Okay, I understand.
It ain't the kind of life I'd wish on nobody.
So, imagine deciding killing yourself is a very hard decision.
Setups I got here. All designed to be foolproof death traps. None of them worked. Always some managed to go wrong. So I figure with this last one, worst case scenario, I get buried alive and can't do no harm to nobody. No backing out of it. I tell you, my luck ain't a blessing. It's a curse.
If you're right about your luck, then won't this likely fail too?
You're probably right, but I gotta try. Like I said, at least this way, I put myself away in a tomb I can't get out of.
Oh, fascist day. Wait. Fast knock. Sorry. Alice in Wonderland got me. But you're not mindless like feral ghouls.
Not yet. How do you think those ferals get that way? All I know is I can't be around people. Myself away.
What if you don't change?
I only run across a few others like me. They were all worried about the same. What if? No one's got any idea. Ain't exactly a doctor around who knows how this all works. So yeah, maybe I'm fine. Maybe Maybe I live another 100 years and not nothing goes sideways. But you seen all them fears out there. Way more of them than there is like us. I don't want to take no chances. This unnatural walking corpse of a body. It ain't no way to live. Say I go back with the Instahelm. What happens if I change for the worse and end up killing others? And what happens if people have trouble putting me down? So I end up killing them all. What then?
Excuse me. That's certainly a concern. We'll deal with it if it comes.
You're gonna put your money where your mouth is? If I do this job for you, you gotta help me off myself after it's done. It's gotta be you.
Nobody
else knows about this.
You got it. I will help you kill yourself in order to protect others.
And you've got a deal. I'll be counting on you. Remember, not a word to the others about what I was out here doing or why. Not even Fisher. Don't want them thinking less of me. And I don't want to cause any fright. Now, let's hear about this jaw.
We need your demolition skills to break into Vault 79.
Sounds crazy, but I can do it. I'm in. You go on ahead back to the crater. I gotta get things in order right here, so nothing happens to it while I'm gone. Meet you there.
I imagine. The Red Riding Hood is one of the very...
Don't mean I'm happy about it.
Is a very popular story to tell. I want to talk to Fisher about this freaking collar thing. Where is he?
It's back again. Still haven't seen who, if that's what you're here for.
Another truck. I gotta probably end this mission before I can get any new options with him.
Day 7-6. Took you long enough to come back. You get Lou on board with the plan?
Sorry I wasn't home. I had to go look for him. He's in for the job.
Okay, good. Lou's our way in the front door, so I don't know how we'd do it without him. Alright, so I've been thinking about those plans. The place is secure as hell. Once Lou gets us inside, I'm sure we're gonna meet resistance. Ain't gonna just bowl over and let us loot, so we're gonna need the big guns. For that, we need Gale. Gale's the big green mutant gal you may have seen around, always hanging out with her little girl, Ra-Ra. Ever since Ra-Ra met up with Gale in the wilderness, they've been impossible to separate. So, just saying, you may have to convince Ra-Ra to let Gale come with us. Good luck, 7-6. To do the trick. If any of my people turn scorched after this,
is it this type? Lou chewed me out real good over letting you know. He's got a real anger streak in him sometimes. You'd think after everything we've been through, he could learn a thing or two about forgiveness. It may be he.
Fisher, you're very interesting, dude.
He thinks I'll always be here for him. But we both know with his longevity that won't always be the case. God help.
Are you a religious man, Fisher?
Once upon a time. I was born and raised Amish. It's hard to shake what you're brought up to believe since birth. No matter how bad this was.
What? You're the tech guy! Were you Amish when the bombs dropped, or did you, like... In Amish cultures, they have their like moment of adult where they get to leave the compound to see what the real world is, and they get to decide if they're going to stay, join the real world, or if they're going to come back to the compound. Did he leave during that, or did he leave because the bombs dropped? How do you go from Amish to here?
After the war, my faith wavered. Anyone could understand that. But to some in my community, it vindicated them. They believed their survival meant they walked the true path. I couldn't be among that mindset.
Wait.
So I used Rumspringer as my chance to leave.
Rumspringer? Do you still believe?
I believe faith is a weakness in this world.
If you so he was Amish when the bombs dropped. They said after the war.
I no longer believe in the God I was raised to worship. I put my faith in hard work and my loyalty in those that have proven themselves. It's just the mannerisms I can't seem to shake.
Oh. I didn't know that that happened with the Red Riding Hood. Because I only know the American story. But, faith can help people survive.
For some, it's all they need. They just have to be smart about it. Prayer won't put food on your table or heal your wounds. It can only give you strength from within.
It has to motivate you. If it's not motivating you, it's hindering you.
Before we met Meg, I could finally see how the faith I had was a hindrance to my own survival. Sometimes I think Lev even gets it right more than Meg. Meg has heart, which can be a risk. Lev won't think twice about taking someone out. I often sided with Meg whenever Lev gets that itch because of my friendship, if you can call it that, with Lou. Lou needs a leader like Meg. With Lev, he wouldn't last a month just because he's a ghoul.
Which is sad.
Lou chewed me out real good over... He's got the real... It may be, but we both know.
Lou needs a friend. You did the right thing.
You think I brought hell itself down on that man? I only ever look out for him. I guess I ought to get back to work. At least I can distract myself with the endless amount of improvements and repairs that need to get done.
Yeah, there.
You idiot. They can still kill you, you know.
The hell? Okay.
To help. Maybe I make them help. But how? Gale needs help. No time to waste making talks with newbies. Go away, stupid human.
I didn't know that the Germans did that. Wait, what's your problem? I'm the one who needs your help.
You need help? No. Gale needs help. Gale don't like your attitude. Gale don't like your face. You just like the others. They see Gale angry. I say help. They say Gale can help self. But they no listen. Gale don't want to crush you.
That's really sad that they did that for World War II.
No one help. Then they listen, maybe.
I don't think crushing them incentivize them to help help
maybe
you.
Not, but it make Gale feel better and send message to others.
Not if you kill them all.
I explain problem. I say she gone. They no understand. They say calm down. Stop yelling. Don't throw things. Stop breaking arm. But no one listens.
Stop
no
breaking
one
arm.
Helps. Someone
bruh.
Say, maybe Gale is just hungry, so they give meat. Gale no want meat. Not now. Not while Gale need help.
Not now.
Gale want to scream.
I know this isn't a laughing matter, because I know what the fact is. But there's just this fact that this is super mutant cracks me up. I'm sorry, Gale, you're right. Let me help you.
That better. Gale is right. Finally, you understand. This is good.
You will help Gale find her.
Find who? Sure, Gale. Just something I need to do.
Find Rara. Rara is in danger. Go get her.
Okay. No time to waste. Tell me where she is now and how to save her.
Went into pipe at big steel place, but Gale too big. So Gale need you to go after Rara. Gale waited and called to Rara, but Rara did not come back. So Gale is worried. Gale come back for help to get human to go in pipe to get Rara. But no one listened to Gale until you. Now you go to pipe and go get Rara out. Easy for someone small and weak like you.
Oh. Interesting. Got it. I'll head this Grafton Steel and see if I can find Rara. You can count on me.
Good. One more thing. If you be nice to Rara and she like you, she will be good and helpful. If she don't like you, she make things hard for you. Rara loves Gale, so life is easy. You are stranger, though, so keep in mind. Now go. Hurry. No time to wander wasteland doing stupid things while little child is in trouble.
Other bullshit creatures you'll run into
on your way down there. Count me out. I think it's time to pay those
inventory. How much do I have on me? Okay. Get rid of that. I'll show you what gold bullion does when we get through this main quest, actually, because that's what introduces it. But the basics of it is that since what we found out from the last stream, the Vault 79 has all of the gold from the U.S. So our entire currency basically is locked in there. Or the gold that backs up our money, basically. And that is gold bullion. And, can I trade with you again?
Tell Rand to make sure people keep a lookout for salvage supplies on any next raid. That last haul is beyond repair.
Oh, because they're broken. But anyways. So with the gold bullion, it becomes a specific trading tool for different types of stuff, which is really cool. Oh, sorry, I was reading your thing. I think that's fair. Is like, I never, honestly, I haven't thought that much into Red Riding Hood in a very long time. Not since I was making her costume. How much do I have some spoiled meat on me? Interesting. Okay. I want to take a look at my side quests. A little bit. Talk to Davenport. Oh, I don't want to do the the bucket list again. That kind of sucked doing the first time. Okay. How close am I to leveling up? Not very. Okay. I want to... Well, I haven't even been to Grafton Steel yet. Let's activate... No. Activate this camp. I'm gonna use the last little bit I have to wind down and also do a little bit of camp building. Since if... Because the rah-rah mission takes longer than 14 minutes. And if you end in the middle of that mission, it makes you start it over. So I don't want to end in the middle of it. I still don't have any of the concrete that I need. So, doors. Okay. Do that. So let's get a little bit of this camp put back together. And this is gonna be our... Oops. Sorry, I forgot how to place, how to rotate things for a moment. Okay. Hey. I'm not gonna lie, the delay is a little annoying. Is that? Can I? Come on. Come on. Come on. Seriously. Fine, let me stack it at least. Whatever. I don't care. I just want to be able to power... my house. There. Okay. Doors, stairs, roofs. No. Chairs. Ooh. Tea time! I love tea time! Place. Come on. Let's go do some tea time to wrap this up. Thank you. It really does, actually. I haven't looked into a story like that to see all the discrepancies and all the lore. Man, I hope people show up. I'm gonna wait a little bit. My stream might go like a few minutes longer, but I want to I don't want to put myself in a pickle. Just for the sake of, just for the sake of getting through an event. Because this pickle, because this event sucks when you don't have enough people. These people really do like hanging out here, huh? Like, I'll give it a few minutes, and if no one shows up, then I'm just gonna go back to what I was doing. So, I'm pretty sure if the event doesn't start, then the event just... I don't start the boilers, and the event just doesn't happen. But we'll find out, so I'm not doing this by myself. Of course, have a wonderful night, Josh. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you Wednesday with some Skyrim. Be good, behave, stay out of trouble, and or don't get caught, and I will say goodnight to Cheshi for you. I believe he went off to bed again. So I will be sure to let him know. True. Oh, cool. Hi. Are you gonna start it? You're starting it.
The boilers are here.
Yep. Fricker. Buzz off, you frickin' little rodent. You got that. It's fine. Ugh. Oh, Jace. Can't see. I can't see. Mother fricker. Man, it's gonna. Fricker. Thank goodness. Mother fricker. I hate doing this stuff very last second. Is it in this event? It does not even matter your levels.
Shame such violence is required to get a proper cup of tea. Water temperature in the
What the frick is happening? I don't even know if y'all can even. I'm not even watching the OBS to see. Mother fricker! Who has a fat man? I need to put a scope on this gun. I keep forgetting to. What is that?
Oh, there's the whistle. The key is steeped now at the perfect and precise 205.
Man, what did I get out of that? Where are my notes? Nothing? I am going over to my base. And we're gonna wrap up. time. Believe it or not. Why is it whenever I do events on the stream, they usually start very poorly? Excuse me. Okay. Oofta. Anywho. We're going to call it there for the night. And I will see you all on Wednesday. Give me 1 second. Let's get on out of here. So thank you guys so much for watching. That was Fallout 76. We got to start in the final home run of the main quest with the Overseer. So my plan is that I'm going to work a little bit with the Raiders, and then I'll do a little bit with Foundation, and from there we're going to make a decision on who we're going to side with to open up the vault, because you can only pick one. And the Foundation does off doing the, this is a mission that people don't normally do. Like, only 2% of players have actually gotten this achievement to finish this mission, and I am one of them. I have finished this before. I'm not going to tell you all my path I chose, but if you're paying attention, you ought to know. However, thank you guys so much for watching. And until next time, be good, be hey, stay out of trouble, and or don't get caught. And I will catch you guys next time. Bye.